dear children, hope you all are fine. Today we are going to learn about the skeleton. The skeleton which gives the shape and support to our body and also protects the internal organs of our body. So we need to learn more about it. Okay, let's go through the chapter. Skeletal system. The skeleton is a framework of bones in our body. The human skeleton consists of the skull, backbone, ribcage, and limbs. It provides the shape and structure to our body and also protects the internal organs. Children, do you know how many bones there are in the human body? When a baby is born, it has about 300 bones. Many of these bones fuse together as the baby grows up. So, an adult skeleton has 206 bones. We already mentioned about the skull, backbone, ribcage, and limbs, which are the important parts of the skeletal system. Now we are going to learn about the skull. Children, look at here. A boy is playing football. The ball hits at the person's head who is lying down under the tree. But notice one thing, how it doesn't cause any injury to his brain. Because the skull protects the brain as a helmet. Yes, skull. It encloses and protects the brain like a helmet. A skull has 22 bones. The upper part of the skull is hard and consists of 8 bones. The face region is made of 14 bones. Out of these, only lower jaw bone can move. It enables us to speak and eat. Then the next one is backbone. Children, the skull is attached to the backbone. The backbone is made of 33 butterfly-shaped bones called the vertebra. And the backbone also called the vertebral column or the spine. The backbone supports our body and supports our spinal cord. Then the next one, rib cage. The rib cage consists of 12 pairs of curved bones called ribs. The ribs are attached to the spine at back and to the breastbone in the front. The lowest pair are attached only to the backbone. They are floating ribs. Then the important function of rib cage is the rib cage encloses the heart and lungs and protects them from injury. Next one is limbs. Children, what are limbs? The arms and legs are called limbs. The arms are attached to the shoulder bones. The upper arm has one long bone called humerus. The lower arm has two bones. The upper arms join the lower arm at the elbow. Many small bones make up the wrist and hand. Then, the thigh bone or femur is attached to the hip bones. It is the longest bone in the body. The lower leg has two bones. The upper leg meets the lower leg at the knee. The many small bones make up the ankle, foot and toes. Then, which is the smallest bone in our body? The smallest bone in our body is present inside the ear. It is called stapes. Now, functions of the skeleton. The skeleton gives shape, support and strength to the body. The skeleton protects delicate organs inside our body such as brain, heart and lungs. The long bones such as the bones in the arms and legs are hollow and are filled with soft jelly-like substance called bone marrow. Children, now we are coming to the summary. The skeletal system provides support and protection to the organs and also helps in the movement. The skeleton consists of the skull, backbone, ribcage and limbs. The long bones, such as the bones in the arms and legs, are hollow and are filled with a soft jelly-like substance called bone marrow. The blood cells of our body are made in the bone marrow. The thigh bone or femur is the longest bone in our body. The smallest bone of our body, stapes, present inside the ear. Children, check these revision questions, okay? I think it's good to revise these questions. Children, I hope you all understood today's lesson. So please stay tuned for the upcoming.